Hi, beautiful ones. It's Audrey, Audrey Light Language, spiritual architect and energy engineer. And I'm here because I have some more automatic writing messages to share with all of you. So I hope you'll stay with me and get to listen to what came through for me to share with all of you. I'm going to just start with a little bit of light language and language of the Akash, whatever comes through for all of you. Semanatur var haniamakdai iseperun ut umayam. Semer duru uv apikash makakasai makasai makasai. Semete kosh tipikosh tipikosh akaki. Eseme shapar tur verum iseperim aturvi. Semaru suru turu urum ikte kasha semikatieti. Semana se henna henna ne henna henna ne henna henna ne Ismete tutum kasha pekita at aru Sevaruturu usimikte kasha Isaparanu suru imirto Sum aktai Isepekte ush apkta Semeru turu siripiktika ai, isemeketaru umeketai umakatai. Semeketai, 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 esh, 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 esh. Semera ture vi sepi, kekeshe, keshe, keshe, keshe. Sumuru tu ut a it erea, sepe ut, ut eme kosh, isipit kosh, tk, esh, tk, ek, tk, akaki. Isumi ut eme it ad. Ome kosh, kata ek, she. Epikasha kutu usikt akaki. Ke semekoshen or ut everati. Semeran use vera serepure. Kemenkasha susu semekadesh epikatai. Semekatai, 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 shiktuk akaki. Iseme ut uteverium. Separium kekash makase, tutu ut eme kosh, eferen usiviriturum aksai, 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 kesesi, kesasi, kesasi, sheri, kesesa, kesesa, kesesa. Okay, beautiful ones. I'm going to read some of the messages for all of you. Okay, so bear with me, and here we go. This I received a few days ago, so April 2017. It says, you will be fully ignited soon. You will be ignited soon. There is a coming catastrophe that is going to open the vaults of knowledge. Now please do be not in fear and just get stuck on that word, catastrophe. And as we are going on, okay, no fear. So let me finish reading the rest of the message. That's going to open the vaults of knowledge that humanity must be thrust into a new understanding of the old. But in the newness of the new, since old truths revealed to be implemented, you see, and upgraded to move them to a new day's arrival. Gone will be the story that was before, and with it hidden the truths of existence. Change must occur to move them from their reverie. Now, for those of you, reverie, so I looked it up because that's not something that I would write. Right? I'm not writing this. They're writing this. And reverie. They wanted to use reverie. I'm like, okay, we're using reverie. Reverie, when I looked it up, I had an idea of what it is, but just for all of you. Reverie, an act or state of absent-minded, daydreaming, fanciful, or illusionary notion. That's the way they picked that name. That word, sorry. Here we go. Change must occur to move them from their reverie. Please listen. There will be great change on a global front. The world leaders will be shaken from their stances they hold now. It is the time of the great reveal. There is nothing that can stop it. It is the turning of the tides. Do as you do. They're talking about me with the coding. There is a great tidal wave of change on the horizon that has not hit your shores as yet, but soon it shall break upon your shores. It is the new beginning you've all worked so hard for. There is coming a great change upon the horizon that soon will hit your shores. Be in your hearts. Be in the beingness of your high selves. And be awoken, humanity, to who and what you are a part of. And with that new knowledge, decide how and what you will be from there onward in your expressions of experience. From the states of sleep to the states of wakefulness, seeing the effects that your dreaming states had created and birthed, and now you have the opportunity to birth anew, which you will do from an awakened state of being with knowledge and information that before was hidden that now will be revealed to you in your wakeful states. Do not be in fear. Be triumphant that you have gotten this far and to this point, and with that triumphant energy and armed with the knowledge, step off the ledge with what you now know. Step off the edge and fly as the butterfly and soar as the phoenix into the new day that you will create. Now, the word knowledge, I've said that before. They're saying knowledge is like now at the ledge, now at the edge. And the ledge of knowing, yes, and having knowledge, and you go forth in that and soar. Here we go. From the place of triumphant remembrance and the power that knowledge gives you, create now from a wakeful state of awareness and knowingness, standing in your beingness of that which you are. Then, from where you created before in forgetfulness of the selfhood and sleeping states. Yes, you dream reality into being. Yes, you express reality into being to experience through your expression. Do so now, not from sleeping, dreaming states of forgetfulness of self that has created the things of nightmare. But instead, dream from a peace-filled state of knowingness, awareness. Create the things that dreams are made of. Dream dreams, beautiful dreams, sweet and bountiful, filled of dreams, fulfilled with joy, peace, abundance, and love to fill and nourish and heal you from and of, rather than the nightmares created from sleeping in a state of forgetfulness and restless dreaming, then the peaceful sleep of sweet dreams. So dream, sweet dreamers, weavers of your reality, to experience and express through. Yet you sleep, but you now will sleep as a lucid dream now, one in which you control the experience while sleeping yet. Awake and knowing and having control within it. Awaken from your nightmare-filled sleep of unrest and discord to one of a sleep you are lucid and aware within, to express and experience and dream beautiful dreams and witness and experience the joy and peace that one finds in peace-filled, joy-filled, full-filling, nourishing sleep, filled with beautiful dreaming and dreams fulfilled. sweet dreams. Dream your beautiful dreams. Sweet dreamers, dream your beautiful dreams. As you create dreams fulfilled, a world and existence to experience from in and within. Sweet dreams, beautiful ones, and may all your sweet dreams be fulfilled. And that is going to be titled, and which I believe I put in the title already in the beginning when you saw the video, Awakening in the Dream, thusly, lucid dreaming now. No more forgetfulness, yes, and what that created, but lucid dreaming and control of the dream. Now, I was hesitating because I really didn't want to talk about and bring forward something that begins with a message with that word catastrophe in it. So they actually then, today, April 30th, 2017, and when you add that all up, we have 4/30/2017, which is 17, and then it becomes an 8, right? 8 infinity. I received another message, and this was from Source, the One, thusly, perfect timing with the 8, you know, and this is what they wrote, and I'm sharing with all of you. It begins with me, and then it turns into a message for everyone, because I was writing for me. So, and then it turned a message for all of you guys, which I'm sharing, so I'm just going to share it from right from the beginning, and here we go. Dearest One, all is well. Tell them what is, so they need to hear it. Tell them it is not going to affect everyone, just a portion. It is not going to affect the states. Now, when you speak of states, yes, states of awareness, state of mind, those in a particular state of beingness, yes, and state of mind, right? It is going to occur in certain parts of the world stage, and they underline stage, the world stage, they underline that. So many things play out on there, you know? The stage, and then there's the behind the stage, yes, all the things that go on, right? Behind the curtains, multiple agendas. So there they go, proper word, stage. Certain parts of the world stage, and they say, they wrote stage and they underline it, so they go to me, yes, stage, the word they wanted to use. Where certain things are played out, you see, to turn the corner for a new day, it is all necessary to get the attention of those that otherwise will not be gotten, to force their hand, you see, to move a mountain that otherwise wouldn't be moved. Except from necessity, which will be the thing that will move it, you see. So yes, tell them, and also to focus on the rest of the message, where the importance of the message is. And that was one that I have just read to all of you. So in case you want to be hung up on that one word, no, please listen to the rest of the message. And here we go. It says, now, for all of you, beautiful dreamers, waken to thee. And also to me. Yes, me, Source, and thee. Thee and Source, all one and the same. All of you and Source, all one and the same. So go on. Beautiful dreamers, waken to thee. This is little parentheses, me. One and the same. Different versions of the selfhood, but the same. You need to tell them it is Source which speaks this message to them. They need to hear it. The message is a simple one, but is the key. Awaken to the truth of that which you are. Source in expression to experience itself as the all that it is. And you are that. You are it. I am you in expression to experience all, the experiencer and the experience. One and the same, the masterpiece and the master, the artist and the work of art, the observer, the witness, and that being witnessed and observed. You as me, source, life and expression of beingness, to know itself, to experience itself in all the expressions of itself, the dream and the dreamer of the dream. For we are dreaming existence, life, into beingness, as we, as I, birth it forth to be expressed and experienced. We are life. We are life expressed, expressed into beingness. We are beingness expressed through being. You are beingness. You are being you as no other can be, just as you are unique and precious to the selfhood and its expression and its uniqueness of beingness through your expression, your expressions, which are your creations. See the master and the masterpiece? One and the same. The master who is a creator and the work of art created, that is expressed through the creator, the work of art expressed birth forth from the master's hand, and you all are master, and you create with, within, and through existence, and throughout existence, within and through me, life force, life source, source of existence as the forces to create life and birth and move through and by me, which is all of you, as we are me and I am you, and we express. We create, we dream. Portions of the selfhood have an experiment to witness the selfhood in a state of forgetfulness of the self, have entered a state of forgetting that they are the selfhood in expression from an experience, an expression of what can be called sleep, forgetfulness of self and the selfhood, and duality and polarity, density, heaviness, a lessening of the light, which enabled the experience to be expressed through, had occurred as the journey to the lower vibration was entered. All that was created from those states of density and polarity, density, forgetfulness, sleep, so much was the stuff of nightmare's birth. Forgetfulness of the self and the selfhood. And so was witness the self as what it is not. And all that the expressions and experience those states birth in separation of the self from the self and the remembrance of the selfhood and all that it is. The stagnation of this expression and this experience is to be cleared from existence as the time of the nightmares that had been created in forgetfulness and sleeping states, and what nightmares are birth in forgetfulness of self, the experiment, the witnessing, the observation of what is created in birth and experience in forgetful sleeping states is upon its completion. It has been deemed, it has been stated, it has been ushered to all the portions of the selfhood to be returned to the knowing and expression of the selfhood in and from states of remembrance. Re/membered, rejoined, re/called, as in remembering, and called back to the knowing, the remembering, the reinstating, the waking. Thus, you see, awakening. You are waking up. To be reunited to the knowing of the self as part of the selfhood, and to dream lucid dreams, no longer nightmares created from separation and in forgetful states, separated from yourself. And you as part of the bigger picture of the selfhood. You are no longer lost but found to yourself. Yourself is that which you are. You have journeyed far in this expression of forgetfulness. But now you have joined and you arrive home. But now you have journeyed and you arrived home, home to yourself and remembers of that which you are and you are a part of. You are part of the beingness of life in expression as you are life. You are life and expression, beloved. So now welcome home. Home to yourself and to the knowledge that empowers you, that sustains you, that is you. You are life. You are an expression of life, a unique, precious portion of the story of life expressed. Our masterpiece, our creation. Now go forth anew, renewed with the knowledge you now possess in an awakened state of knowing and remembrance of the selfhood. With this knowledge, you are now at the edge, now at the ledge, as our channel has brought forth before. So now jump off the ledge with the power to soar as the phoenix and fly as the butterfly. You are with this knowledge. You are with this knowledge and truth of your beingness now at the edge of tomorrow. So go fly, go soar, go create and explore anew, renewed, with the renewal of yourself to yourself, and create with that power of knowing and understanding as the light which is yours return to you to express and experience through a higher frequency of light vibration as you are raised up, see transformed. Transformation, transfigured, transfiguration, resurrected, raised up in the light poured back unto you to transform, transfigure, resurrect you, to be rebirthed, reborn unto that which you are, a being filled with light, a light being expressing and creating with light. Light up, lighten up, quite literally, in so many ways, filled with light. Higher vibrating and thus creating works of art, masterpieces filled with light. It's you. Sorry. As you express in remembrance and joined, no longer separated, to the self and the selfhood, to express and create and dream the things that dreams are made of. Sweet dreams. Awoken from the nightmares of forgetful sleep to dream lucidly, empowered to affect the dream and the dreaming, birth forth, that the dreamer empowers, experiences, sweet dreams, beautiful dreamers, waken to thee, to yourselves, awaken to me, to the knowing of the self as the selfhood, one and the same. So, beloveds, see the term awakening and ascending, so much talking about, you know. So you're being awoken from states of sleep, forgetfulness, separation of self and forgetfulness in sleep to wake up. And you are being resurrected, transfigured, and transformed in the light, vibrationally from that more light, raised up vibrationally, thusly ascending, going up in vibration and light filled as your energy and vibration, vibrating energy, light in expression, all is light in expression, consciousness expressed, light in expression, consciousness conscious of itself to express and know itself as all that it is, to witness and observe itself as all it is. All that it is. The experiment of witnessing what it is not, returning to the knowing even more fully what it is. It witnessed what it is not, knowing even more of that which it is from having known what it is not. Returning to that which you are. Awakened, ascended, did to all you are. Welcome home. So that was another message for all of you. Now let's see. This is what they were talking about. Kept playing the words to me. Beautiful dreamer, wake unto me. So I'm going to read the words for you of that old song, so we have to go find them. Beautiful dreamer, wake unto thee. Starlight and dewdrops are awaiting thee. Sounds of the rude world heard in the day, lulled by the moonlight, have all passed away. Beautiful dreamer, queen of my song, list while I woo thee with soft melody. Gone are the cares of life's busy throng. Beautiful dreamer, awaken unto me. I must say thee, you say thee, like to yourself, to me, to source, and thee, one and the same. Beautiful dreamer, awaken unto me. Beautiful dreamer, out of the sea. Mermaids are chanting the wild lorelei. And I looked up that what that is, and if back in the day the ship, people were on the ships would say the mermaids were there luring them in, you know, and you can kind of place that in if you say all the things that had gone on with others' agendas to lure you in. You know, what lorelei is, a sung to lead one to their death upon the rocks. Nothing against mermaids. Mermaids are beautiful people, but we're talking about the lore from back in the day to saying in the story about the lorelei, they sang a song to lead them to the death upon the rocks, right? So we can take that as the part of the thing that was so alluring to us, or we took part of in the experiment to know what we are not in forgetful states. Yes, that kind of crashed us upon the rocks. Well, now that's all done now. So here we go to return to our power and understanding and knowing. So finish the words of the song. It's such an old song. Stephen C. Foster, if you want to look it up, the words. So, okay. Over the streamlet, vapors are born, waiting to fade at the bright coming morn. So here we go. See the light, yes? All the vapors are going to fade and it's going to become clear in the light, in the coming morn. Beautiful dreamer, beam on my heart, ear as the morn on the streamlet and sea, then will all clouds of sorrow depart. See, all clouds of sorrow depart. And that's when we awaken and remember, come out of the story, come out of the experiment, take back one's power, divine birthright, stand in your sovereignty, which is all about what my work is about. So here's the last lines of the song. Beautiful dreamer, awaken unto me. Beautiful dreamer, awake unto me. And they were writing, beautiful dreamer, awake unto thee. Like to wake up to yourselves. Then they were talking about going home. So homeward bound. And hold on. Here we go, homeward bound. Marta Keen, and I'll read it to you. In the quiet misty morning, when the moon has gone to bed, when the sparrows stop their singing and the sky is clear and red. It's in the sunrise, right? New day dawning, here we go. When the summer's ceased its gleaming, when the corn is past its prime. Now, if you want to talk about corn past its prime, you know, sometimes they were saying this is the harvest, but in a good way, not anything bad. Harvesting, reaping, collecting, like what back to ourselves, what is ours, and what have we done? What have we made with the time, the forgetfulness, such? And then the beautiful thing is to remember ourselves within all of that, even despite all of that. Thusly, we are triumphant. So here we go. When adventures lost its meaning. And there we go, you know. My work talks about how this has become stagnant over and over, cycle upon cycle. Stagnation. And see, this adventure of this has lost its meaning. It's become stagnant. There's nothing else to get from it. And thusly, why, it's the end of that, closing of that, and opening of the new. So here we go. I'll be homeward bound in time. Bind me not to the pasture. Chain me not to the plow. See, chained to all of this that was before, right? To be freed from that. Set me free, and they underline free, to find, and they underline my calling. Your calling, we're being called, right? Back to the remembrance of that which we are, and take out our power and divine birthright, or stand in our sovereignty. Here we go, the rest of it. And I'll return to you. Somehow, if you find it's me, you're missing. Missing ourselves, that portion of ourselves, right? We call out to source and God and all the prayers and such, right? So missing that portion of ourselves, remember that and be joined back with it and the joy of that, fulfillment, nourishment of that. So if you're hoping I'll return, then the wind will set me racing as my journey nears its end. And the path I'll be retracing when I'm homeward bound again. right? Well, we're tracing the same path, right? From source, the story, the cycles, retracing, but now coming back to home, right? Bind me not to the pasture, chain me not to the plow. Set me free to find my calling, and I'll return to you somehow. So there you go. Let's see, what do they write? See, this is where I'm right saying this. They wrote it. This is where the eternal now moment is, right? Bound home. Homeward bound. Right? Now, bound, you could say, is your destiny, your journey, where you're going. You're bound there, right? And you're also bound, as in tied. So we're tied to go home, bound to go home, both ways, bound, that's where we're going. As we're going on the journey, we're bound to get there because that's the only place there is to go, and we are bound, tied, as in tied, there's nowhere else to go. So we're tied to go back there, you know, to go home. So thusly, the homeward bound, to find yourself in remembrance, is what they're saying, remembered, joined back to. So they were saying about the homeward bound, and they say, you are bound, as in bound to their, as bound to return, for there is nowhere else to go. Bound as in tied, for you are bound and tied to return there. And bound as in journey, going, you are bound somewhere, as going somewhere, right? Going home. Here we go. Now we have another song. Everyone knows Paul Simon. It's a little bit different words. It says, I'm sitting in a railway station, got a ticket for my destination. Ah, a ticket for a destination. I always tell sometimes my clients, we got a ticket to be here. We had got a ticket to ride, right? So now we have a ticket for the destination, which is joined back to ourselves. So on a tour of one night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned. For a poet and a one-man band. Homeward bound, I wish I was homeward bound. Home where my thoughts escaping, right? We're always thinking of that so many times, right? Peace and calm and unity and love and nourishing and being fulfilled and feeling peace and beauty, right? Home, the souls reaching for that remembrance of that, aching for that. Home where my music's playing, right? Beautiful sounds of peace and joy, right? Sound, it's all sound. Home where my love lies waiting silently for me. One's love, you say source, source, field, God, all there is, source. The love, right? The love, so we so lovingly went on this experiment, this experience to go out and experience all that is, yes, us, source, one and the same, for love. Every day's an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines. Ooh, we could say the poisoning with the cigarettes, right? So much has bombarded us while we were here. And magazines, all of that manipulate our mind and such. Each town looks the same to me, the movies and the factories. And every stranger's face I see reminds me that I long to be homeward bound. I wish I was with homeward bound tonight. I'm longing to be homeward bound. Let's see, I wish I was homeward bound tonight. I'll sing my songs again. I'll play the game and pretend. See, we were pretending, right? I'm playing a game. But all my words come back to me. In shades of mediocrity. Mediocrity, right? It's been become mediocrity. No more. Finished. Stagnation, out of it. Like emptiness in harmony, I need someone to comfort me. Homeward bound, I wish I was homeward bound. Home where my thoughts escaping. Home where my music's playing. Home where my love lies waiting. Silently for me. To return home, home unto yourselves. All right, beautiful one. So those were some of the music that came in that they wanted me to read to you. So you have that homeward bound, and then you have that beautiful dreamer, awaken to thee, right? So we were dreaming before, and now we're going to have more as we are still dreaming, because we are dreaming creation, we are dreaming life, we are dreaming beingness, we are experiencing it, but not from dreaming of sleeping states or forgetful states, which nightmares were born of, but now lucid, correctly, which as you understand lucid, you control it. You understand, you're perfect, you have awareness in it. So now we dream anew, yes? And lucid dream is taking back our power and we go create beautiful works. So beautiful ones, Audrey Light Language, extension of the name, because light language is beautiful and so powerful. But again, my work is so much, even so much more there than the beautiful light language and the power of that, the language of the Akash. We do not go in and read the Akash. Yes, we go in and recode it for the new. We're talking about the new day, not the old to read, but the new for the coding and such to go forth. Yes? So the language of the Akash, the language of light, the sacred key code numbers, because I'm a coder. I do the work in the field of existence and also with all of you codings, upgrades, helping you for all that is going on. Yes, it is scientifically proven that the energy is raising and the numbers are raising, but it's again for us to help each one or whoever finds they need help in this experience that's going on with their physical vessel going through things and mentally, emotionally. It's also cleaning out house, cleaning out all the old energetics and what we're entwined in, plugged into habits formed eons and eons of time, the same energy perpetuated over and over again, to release, to let go of that. And then take in the upgrades and the codes. You have a long list, 50, 60, 70, 80, 100 long of numbers that are yours. And then you can work with encodings and work that were done, that work is done on you. The fairies come in, the ancients, the native ones, to help release deep generational things. It's work as conscious, unconscious, subconscious, etheric, mental, physical, emotional bodies of the self. Also childhood things. So as you do this work, this eternal now moment, you help and affect what would be a future you. There is no time, but if you want to look at it in human referencing point, as the future you is upgraded, yes, as you went to mastery school, to help you with these energies and things that are going on, to adjust and go through it, you know, much more easily and more comfortably, and to help bring in more and more of that light at a comfortable level, and even more and more that you'd be able to take in as you're upgraded, you know. So beautiful ones, my work is so important. I do not do this for my living. Maybe a lot of people do it, and that's beautiful that now this is a way to be there for many to make their living, because it's a joyous way to do it as part of the new day. I do this because spirit had come in. I did not study with anyone. I did not have to go anywhere. They levitated me, turned me all back on of that who I am, an ancient beingness and creation, working with creation always, time traveler, so to say, one who goes and works with existence, motion, movement, setting things in place so then others can partake of it, for things to move in motion because it's set in the system, in the field. So again, I'm back in embodiment to do the work, to help set the things in the field, and then also for the individuals who come that are drawn to me. Spirit moves people all around the world. I have clients that are led to their soul inkling and reaching and understanding and feeling to have this done. I've had people in meditation and in intuition say, go to Audrey, get the numbers, get what she go and get what she has to give you. So the work is so important. And I'm available through Skype all around the world. Okay, so you guys can connect with me. So you can start to get some help on this process of this beautiful awakening and ascending, pouring in the light. And dream is what you weave will be beautiful dreams, moving out of that state of forgetfulness. Yes, so beautiful ones. I'm going to speak some light for you right now, but I'm going to say AudreyLightLanguageChannel.wordpress.com. Hummingbird is probably the easiest and quickest way to get me, the hummingbird1211@gmail.com. Let me know you're interested in a session and we could set up the days for you of when we can begin your work to help you release and let go of things that are no longer needed energetically, release from them, disentangle from matrices, like I said, in old energies, and be downloaded, help to adjust you with new energies and such, okay? New frequencies and codes to help acclimate yourself with all of that. A long time ago, Spirit, when I had first begun, had said to me, for many of them, it's going to feel as if they were thrown into a cold water or a lake or a pool or something like this, right? Shock to their system to some. But if they do the work, it's like they acclimate. Helps them to feel as if they've walked into the lake or the cold water. So you're acclimating yourself rather than shock, you know, of just being hit with all of that. So please connect with me. 347-840-2711 is another way to connect with me, so you could have get your appointment. And it really is reasonable. Because again, as I was saying, I do this because Spirit has opened me up again to that I am, right? Because I have my regular life, my wife, I'm a wife, you know, children, friends, family, all these things going on. So I do this because Spirit moves me, just as in the writing, to bring it forth for all of you. And then I take time in my regular life to do this and be Audrey Light Language, spiritual architect, energy engineer, and be tapped into the reason why I'm here, to work with creation and work with beautiful individual ones, besides being Audrey Light Language. But it is not like a profession or a business, something that I do for that. You know, my hubby's like, why are you doing this? You know, come, let's go do this. You know, we take beautiful walks to the park, feed the squirrel, feed the birds, you know, take a drive in our beautiful 1969 Chevelle, you know, and such. So, but then I take this time, as moved by spirit, of the importance to have also a few hours in my life to take time to do this work with you, because it is so important. So again, if you would like to take advantage of the opportunity of this cycle is now giving to those who will take advantage of it, to awaken, to take part of that, because if you look on YouTube, there's other messages that I have out there through automatic writing about now is the time of the great divide. So which side of that great divide you're going to be on? One that leads to like to be dissolved, you know, or one that is of life and beauty and new and creation of that and being in energy frequency for that, you know, and dream beautiful dreams. So beautiful ones, connect with me again, Audrey Light Language, spiritual architect, energy engineer, Audrey Light Language, and hummingbird1211 at gmail.com. You could find me there. I'm just going to speak a little. Fairies want to come in for all of you guys. And beautiful ones, also, they're having me say to you, you know, I come in and I shatter your filters, because the filters were before, of what it was before, sleep and forgetfulness, for a purpose for that, but it's no longer needed. So it's to shatter them, you know, because the filter is another thing. They're going to get messages, but it becomes through their filter, and then the filter affects it. So it's very pure messages through the one, through source, as I come in to shatter filters, and I don't have that filter issue. So I help you to eliminate, get rid of, shatter your filters in the work. So it's very important, because that is no longer needed anymore, you know, to have clearly, see clearly in clarity, because you know there's a way to see and a way to hear, but it was this seeing and hearing before, but now in the new day is to see and hear with clarity and beingness, and no longer needed the filter. So I help with that, with the work that is done. Okay, beautiful ones, so connect with me. And I wish you much, much love. And I have another two messages, but I don't want to keep this going on and on and on. So look for the other one that I'm going to put up, okay? So much love, beautiful ones. Much love, much love. Okay, bye. Thanks for spending time and listening.